All right, this is the off-grid amateur here. This is not something I normally do, but this is a build in a Toyota Camry, 2012 Toyota Camry. I'm doing this for an acquaintance. This is what I've built so far. They want to try living out of their car. They want to be able to move around. They don't want to have to pay rent and give them some freedom. So I'm just going to run you through the build of the bed. That over there is actually a toilet, but you can't tell right now because it's covered. And then I'll show you the positive air pressure ventilation system that was installed as well. But the bed is made out of 1-inch plywood, and 1-inch plywood doesn't really require any framing. It's really thick. I was able to find it inexpensively on Facebook Marketplace. Big sheets that were roughly 4x4 sheets for about $10 each. But looking back through here, this is where you would have your legs when you're sleeping. These handholds allow the user to pick these up and move them out of the way if necessary, and they've got these alignment pins that allow the user to lock them into position so they don't slide away from you while you're sleeping. She's got a 4-inch mattress or 3-inch thick memory foam mattress going to sit on top of this. And it was important when we built this to make sure that the car could be restored to its original condition, so that if she ever sells this and upgrades to a van, she's not going to lose money on it because she's modified it and did something that wasn't reversible. But the headrest portion with a piano hinge, a couple of supports here for the outside edge, but this just folds up and lays flat. Then you've got the upright support that goes down to the floor that holds this up, so that'll bear weight. And this is on a hinge, so it swings out and supports the headrest when it goes down, so that allows you to put some weight on that as well. And then using what was already here in the vehicle, and it doesn't even require us to move these to lift this up, but when you pick this up, that upright swings back and out of the way. And these brackets right here were already on the seat. They were there already, and that's what secures the seat. So I just used what was here to give her the best advantage. And they pivot and support the weight of the plywood. I just ran some carriage bolts and fender washers through there. But when you lower the bed down, this support falls down to the floorboard, and then you swing this support out and you can throw the headrest up, and then making sure that these are in their designated location to give you a nice flat smooth surface to sleep on. All right, so I'm gonna put the mattress in. Okay, the mattress is in. It's just one of them tri-fold memory foam mattresses. We did have to cut out of it a piece of foam. We just let the fabric on there, but the foam cut out around the console, so this will fit. You place a pillow here, and this is where the head's gonna rest. And the feet will go through the opening in the trunk. We saved the original seats so we can put them back in later if she ever decides to sell the car. And then, of course, this over there, I'll go around to the other side. When it's not being used for the obvious reasons, a toilet, anytime you can use a regular flush toilet, that'd be great. But middle of the night, you don't want to get out of the vehicle. You got to go number one. It's a great option. This surface, put a little bit of, I think, cabinet or shelf liner material to give a little more friction. But it will be like a work surface, set a computer, laptop, tablet, beverages or whatever. And when you're not using it, set up in the middle of the night. You take this, get it up out of the way, either down on the floor or preferably in a front seat. But has these alignment pins and these screws that line it up and keep it from shifting around. But this is just one of those luggable loo toilet seats. It's not even sitting on top of a bucket. It's just sitting there loose. You know, but if a person had to go pee in the middle of the night, this is the pan off of one of those bedside toilets that you find in hospitals and nursing homes, or somebody that's like, you know, in poor health at home. So the cover allows you to keep the mess contained. But if this person needs to use the restroom middle of the night, There you go. They can just pivot, drop their feet down in here. They can have this in the front seat or the passenger seat, somewhere out of the way. So that in the middle of the night while they're sleeping, all they gotta do is just pop this lid up and take care of their business. And in the morning, empty and clean this out. This was built also out of the 1-inch plywood. And down underneath here, you got this that goes all the way to the floor. And you got three legs. There's one here on this position. There's one in the middle. And there's one over on the far corner. And they all have these gussets right here. Just angled pieces that don't interfere with how it functions. But give these legs a little more strength so they don't wobble and move around. So this is how this person is going to be able to, go number one in their car while they're living out of it. Hopefully it can give some people some ideas, but these are readily available at places like Walmart and Dick's. I like the Dick's Sporting Goods because it's a little bit better quality than the Ozark Trail. Get everything back to its original condition. And then we'll move on to what I call the positive air pressure ventilation system. But one thing I had to do was I had to cut away a portion of this because I didn't want to modify these ears. And this thing sits down in flush, so I cut away these portions that would normally snap on. These normally snap onto the bucket. And what that's going to do is it allows it to find that spot. And it's not going to move around because the pan itself also has notches where the handle was. So when they nest down in, they don't move around either. So while this isn't permanently attached, it will move and shift a little bit, but I don't think it's gonna be a problem. And the biggest thing, the reason why I did this, is I didn't want this person who isn't too terribly handy or doesn't have a lot of experience, I didn't wanna make a mechanical connection that where this plastic might fail, that she'd have to, try to repair that. If this ever breaks or becomes unusable, she can just pitch it and go get another one. Well, recycle it. And then, of course, putting it back on, you find those alignment holes, and it settles into position, and this doesn't move around at all, and that becomes the surface that they can work on. Now, you see the back window, we got the Reflectix. That's all cut to fit the various windows. I'm sure other people have videos about that, but this is something that addresses warmer climates, what we did here is in the trunk, I've actually cut a hole out in this angled portion right here. I stuffed this in because in behind this is a positive air pressure or vent, air vent. When you slam the doors, it doesn't build pressure and it lets pressure out. It's just a gravity thing. But that 3-inch hole was drilled. Riveted a starter collar, used some Gorilla tape because that stuff's really good for that, and brought it up high enough with a 90, pivoting the different joints to make it come straight up. And then this is an inline duct fan. If you look down in there, you see that fan spinning. And I fit it with this screen. The screen's a dome shape, so it gives you the maximum surface area. And it also prevents insects or mosquitoes from being drawn into your vehicle. It's going to stop them there so that you can crack your front windows. And as long as you've got a gap somewhere in this space while you're sleeping, it's going to create positive air pressure. Obviously, it's not a good idea to do this when the car is running. The exhaust is on the opposite side as over here. And down below, there is those plastic pans. They kind of act as a mud deflector and spray, but all those little holes you see allow air to come in through those holes. And then in cooler weather, when you don't want positive air pressure, you just unplug it and say you don't even want that leaking. Now, well, this is just a friction fit and just a regular cap. Shut the fan off, set the cap on it, and now you don't have a cool air coming inside the vehicle. I'm sure there's going to be tons of questions. I'm almost finished with this build. I got to do some wiring to make sure that the 12-volt plugs will stay on, even when the car is not running, so that she can use her inverter, which will alarm whenever the battery voltage gets low, and even shut off to protect the battery voltage. But an independent power supply to run this would be a better choice, just because then it's not using any of the vehicle's starting battery capacity. And something that you can recharge while you're driving, or even use solar. It isn't going to draw a lot of power. I think that this is a quarter amp at 120 volts. So that's only going to pull about 40 watts when it's running. That's very low draw for that right there. But that you can feel the cool air moving in, and with the trunk closed and the windows cracked, it's going to push that cool air up across the person who's sleeping, and it's going to help to keep the interior from becoming too hot in warmer climate. So this has went on for like 10 minutes. Obviously, if you have any questions about this build, give me a shout. You can leave a comment on the video, and I'll do my best to answer your questions.